Hello everyone, I'm Antsa and welcome back to Let's Play Indianapolis 500 for Arcade. Last time we almost finished Highland Raceway. Now let's do Indy 500. Start your engines.
The race begins from a rolling start.
Let's see how many laps there are.
Ready, go!
20, okay. It's a real achievement to have 33 computer drivers. This game is from 1995. I don't know how far they draw the cars. I can see at least 8 cars ahead of me. Oh! Jesus Christ! Many fatalities there. But somehow no one will retire. Okay, I gained many places there. Yeah. I think many people who watch motor racing secretly hope for crashes and pileups. Obviously, no one wants to see anyone hurt himself or herself, but crashes are wonderful, especially if they are spectacular. Wow, I'm leading pretty soon. But I think the problem will be that I will again run out of time. Curse of arcade games. I didn't like how even console games like Burnout had a counter. It was too arcade for me. The only timing that should matter is timing against other players, not against the clock. It's not realistic. There's no sport, at least motorsport, that has a counter running down. You may have a time limit for the race, but it's usually an hour or 2 hours, but not 100 seconds. It's just silly. So there are different kind of realism. So you can have a realistic graphics, or realistic physics, or realistic rules, and then you can have a realistic properties for the game. And this includes rules for a game. So you can, for example, enable or disable damage. That's completely unrealistic, but for the game it's usually an option. Personally, I like more. I prefer simulators to arcade racing games. But it took a long time to actually have simulators for gaming. Gaming consoles. Oh dear. You could say that modern Formula One games are simulators, but I'm sure that in 20 years no one will think that. Such way. They will look just as ancient as this game. Doing quite similar laps. 37 point something. Is the skybox moving? Maybe it's just the movement of the car. No, I think the skybox actually moves. That's interesting. Be interesting if you could hack these old racing games. For example, you could turn this game into a shooter game. So you would run at the stadium and shoot everything. There are many shooters that can be turned into racing game. For example, I'm not sure if Fallout 4 has a racing mod. I think it might be possible. But to see a racing game turned into a shooter or adventure game, that would be something. But I doubt that there are big modding group for this modding society for these old games. Okay, I think this time I will finish, because I have still plenty of time, unless I'm going to crash all the time. These cars are one lap down, so have to be cautious. Music in this game is much quieter. Whoa! That was close. I think the car went just through me. I should be dead now. I really, appreciate the skills and the braveness of these Indy 500 drivers. Because they are going nearly they are actually going 400 kilometers per hour. So if someone would spin and get stuck at the middle of the road, then he will die and probably the driver that hits him dies as well. So there's always the risk of strategy. But fortunately, fatal accidents are pretty rare. I don't remember what's the last accident at Indianapolis. The risk always remains. I'm always winning. Yeah! First place. It was so close. In the world of racing, legends are few and far between. Those who do reach such legendary status do by the constant driving and pedal sensor machine driver. More importantly, is power fans and other cars. Now we take great pleasure of welcoming Andrew Race in the Racing Hall of Fame. And here's the staff. Couple of non-Japanese guys there. Thank you for playing. Yeah, let's put our name. This might be the only time I have won something for arcade. Where's A? A's in the beginning. Such a shame that this isn't a real arcade. What? Fourth? Oh, it's total time. Alright. Let's see the last track next time. Thank you for watching. See you then.